What if I said that your drinking water contains an element that's used in batteries and that it could also be affecting your mood? Sometimes referred to as the magic ion, this element's name is lithium, and a recent review of decades of research has found that trace amounts of lithium found in the tap could be stabilizing your mood and may even have the potential to reduce the risk of suicide. Of all the elements, lithium is one of the lightest. This soft, silvery white metal occurs naturally in soil, rocks, and many foods. It's also highly reactive, particularly with water, and varying degrees of lithium can be found in surface water, groundwater, and seawater around the world. And not only is it valued for boosting the energy density of our batteries, over the past few decades, lithium has gained recognition in the medical community for its powerful impacts on mental health, too. In fact, today lithium is a standard treatment for bipolar disorder, a mental illness categorized by dramatic mood swings of emotional highs and lows that affects roughly 1 in 100 people worldwide. Lithium is also used when patients with depression don't respond to other medications, as it's recognized as an effective long-term management tool for warding off hospital visits and suppressing suicide attempts. Unfortunately, it can have some pretty bad side effects like hand tremors and headaches when taken in high enough doses. But the doses prescribed and the amount that you naturally get from the tap are very different. Used medically, a prescribed dose typically ranges from a couple hundred milligrams to over 1,000. By contrast, the lithium levels found in a liter of drinking water typically measure anywhere between a fraction of 1 microgram to 200 micrograms, depending on the source. But this incidental exposure isn't necessarily insignificant. Over the past few decades, studies have showed evidence of a relationship between higher levels of lithium in drinking water and lower rates of depression, crime, and even dementia in the general population. Some studies have even suggested an association between higher lithium levels and lower rates of suicide, but not every study has found similar links, and importantly, no comprehensive effort has been made to connect all of this research. Until now. A recent study led by researchers from King's College London and Sussex Medical School set out to synthesize all available evidence of the association between lithium in drinking water and suicide rates. In total, the team identified 415 articles spanning 3 decades, comprising data from over 1,000 regions, counties, and cities around the world. The average concentration of lithium in the water samples ranged from under 4 to over 80 micrograms per liter. By combining the results of multiple studies, the team was able to statistically analyze the data and search for a link, and a link emerged. Their analysis showed that areas with higher concentrations of lithium in their public tap had correspondingly lower rates of suicide. This is the first meta-analysis of its kind, so these findings are hugely encouraging. Still, the team emphasizes that more work needs to be done to explore this relationship. They note that conducting randomized trials that supplement the water supply with lithium would be a great place to start, particularly in communities with high prevalence of mental health conditions, criminal behavior, and substance misuse. So how exactly does this magic ion work its magic? Well, we don't really know, at least not exactly, because lithium is an ion. It interacts with many different target cells in our body and results in a whole host of side effects, making it extremely difficult to pinpoint which interaction affects our mood. However, we do know that lithium interacts with the brain's neurotransmitters, the chemical messengers that help our neurons communicate. When in balance, our billions of neurotransmitters expertly manage virtually all of the body's tasks, from our breathing to how we learn. But if their levels become out of sync, health problems like depression and anxiety can arise. By modulating the response of our neurotransmitters, lithium is thought to restore their proper functioning. The prevailing hypothesis is that lithium promotes inhibitory neurotransmission, which regulates anxiety, while inhibiting excitatory neurotransmitters like dopamine and glutamate, which are elevated during mania. Not only does this recent analysis provide us with further incentive to unpack lithium's effects on the body, it offers us a chance to appreciate water's overall health benefits too. Clean, healthy drinking water contains all kinds of elements and minerals that are vital to human health. Calcium and potassium, just to name a few. In fact, water can help us meet up to 20% of our daily dietary intake requirements for certain elements. And simply staying hydrated can restore balance to our neurotransmitters in our body and literally calm our nerves. Amazing. To be clear, I am not suggesting that you drink raw water. You know, the kind that's unfiltered, untreated, and unsterilized. Running the risk of ingesting harmful bacteria is not worth it. I'm just saying the benefits of water and really anything that we ingest extends well beyond what's obvious on the surface. So cheers to that. Fun fact, when it was first introduced back in 1929, 7-Up contained lithium. Let us know if you would drink lithium soda down in the comments, or if you want us to cover more stories on mental health in the future. Make sure to subscribe, see you next time on Seeker, and thanks for watching.